Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about CSF disseminated metastasis imaging. This condition means that the malignant tumors spread out through subarachnoid space of brains and spinal cord. Presentation. Most common signs and symptoms: headache, confusion, connective impairment, seizure, cranial nerve dysfunction like diplopia, especially CN number 7, trigeminal neuralgia, anesthesia, optic neuropathy, deafness. Weakness leg more frequently than arm. Dermatomal or segmental sensory loss, radicular pain, nocardiology around 15%, disturbance of bowel, bladder function, other signs symptoms, abnormal CSF flow dynamic, in 30 to 70% with obstruction at the level of spine, skull base, arachnoid granulation. Clinical profile adult, typically seen in advanced cancer. Children, minority of patient with certain intracranial tumor type. Demography, epidemiology, 5% of all spinal metastasis prevalent in adult patients is increasing as cancer patients are living longer. Imaging, smooth or nodular enhancement along cord cauda equina, located at any points of CSF pathway. For basic pattern, solitary focal mass at bottom of thecal sac, diffuse, thin, sac-like coating or cord root, carcinomatous meningitis, rope-like thickening of cauda equina, unifocal or multifocal discrete nodule. This is the sagittal FISTA, or we call CIS, in a patient with metastatic posterior fossa epineoma, revealed numerous nodular CSF drop metastasis, the largest compressing the cunus. CIS FISTA imaging is very sensitive for detecting drop metastasis and is recommended for patient. T1 C plus FSMR confirm a weak enhancement of the drop metastasis. This enhancing lesion are easy to detect, but non-enhancing metastatic deposit may be very difficult to identify on T2 and contrast T1 MR. T1 C plus MR in a patient with intracranial diffuse midline pleoma demonstrate a large drop metastasis in the caudal thecal sac. Enhancement is minimal and lesion is subtle for its size. T2 MR in the same patient, so mass effects on the cauda equina by the large metastasis. T2 MR in a patient with port ventricle epineoma, despite a different imaging appearance for nodular drop metastasis, This must have designed in the Gaudadicta site, a common location for CSF metastasis to settle dependently. It is important to always carefully evaluation in this location. Treatment. Radiation therapy for focal tumor, intravenous plus minus intratectal chemotherapy, surgical decompression or cord compression if radiation therapy fail or acute paraplegia. Thank you.